Diego Forlan, who steps forward for Uruguay. And Forlan scores.
And you always feel nervous for the players when they're stepping up there. There's a lot goes through your mind. You've got 40, 45 yards to walk up to take the penalty. You've got an extra 10 seconds to stand and think where you're going to put it if you change your mind. But Diego Forlan's mind was set. It was straight down the middle.
Been a bit of a jumble working out who's going to take the penalties for Uruguay, but they did finally settle on Diego Forlan to take the first. Scotty will be the fourth in line for Uruguay. Nicolas Paticio stepping forward now for Argentina. Lovely penalty by Nicolas Paticio. A 100% record, 2-1 now to Argentina.
Oh, it's a lovely penalty, isn't it? Power, enough height to get it above halfway, which is a goalkeeper's reach. Even though Romero went the right way, the power took it past him.
Suarez steps forward. Suarez, who was red carded at the end of extra time against Ghana at the World Cup. He wasn't involved in that penalty shootout, the penalty shootout that Uruguay won. Muslera can't look. You'll know from the reaction of the crowd whether or not Suarez does score. 2-2.
We'll see quality to win it from penalties, aren't we? No, there's a lot riding on this game, and again he's got enough height to get it above the goalkeeper.
Uruguay had a shootout in one of their preparatory games. They took on the Netherlands, finished 1-1, and then Uruguay successful 4-3 in the shootout. Carlos Tevez now for Argentina. Four penalties taken, 2-2 the score. And Muslera has saved it! Another fantastic save by Fernando Muslera. Kept out that Thunderbolt free kick from Messi during the game itself. And he's done it again now in the shootout.
You know, Carlos Tevez has just purely gone for power. You know, it's not a good penalty. You know, if you're going to go for power, you'd be as well go straight down the middle. But he's just gone just to the angle. It gives the goalkeeper a chance, if he reads it, to block it.
Scotty. The advantage is now with Uruguay. Andres Scotty, the 35-year-old, who had to come on as a first-half substitute, has given Uruguay the advantage.
Well, he stepped up nonchalantly, hasn't he? He's came into the game unexpectedly. He's come on, he's enjoyed the game, and he just stepped up very confidently to put it away.
Scotty, who scored in the shootout in the quarterfinals at the World Cup. Pastore, one of Argentina's substitutes. Oh, nearly again, Muslera managed to get a hand to that. And Argentina hanging on.
Hit it low and hard. When the goalkeeper's coming down, it just hits his elbow, goes under the body. It just had enough power to sneak under him. Well, that's a big weight off one so young's mind.
Walter Gargano. They wait and some watch, not all. Brilliantly taken penalty by Walter Gargano.
That's almost a perfect penalty. You know, he's come round it, hits the side netting. You know, the goalkeeper can't get there. It's above the height that he wants to dive at. It's a fantastic penalty by Gargano.
Higuain, who has to score to keep Argentina in the Copa. Defied repeatedly during the game by Muslera. He's already denied Tevez. Oh, it's just squeezed in off the underside of the crossbar.
Well, he's went for the power and the height, and I'm not so sure it's hit the goalkeeper going back in. It's hit the bar. No, it's not. It's, you know, a bit of luck, bit of spin in the ball. When it comes back down, goes back up off the bar and sneaks in. Sometimes that might be a bit of luck, puts the pressure on the next player to take the penalty.
If Martin Caceres scores, Uruguay are in to the semi-finals. Caceres to take Uruguay through, and he's done just that. A magnificent set of penalties, and Uruguay here against all the odds have beaten the hosts. Argentina are out, and Uruguay have got such a dreadful record in Copa shootouts. I've seen that barren run ended the last time.